Hello kids, today we're gonna talk a little bit about Earth and gravity. Have you ever wondered what keeps us from floating off into space? Why does something we drop fall to the ground? It's called gravity, or the natural phenomenon by which physical bodies attract each other, with a force proportional to their masses. Actually, it does more than keeping everything fall towards the ground. It makes the Earth circle around the Sun. It makes the moon cross our skies, but also it makes the Earth spin. Today we are going to talk about all of them, but first we have to find out how the gravity was discovered.
Once upon a time there was a man called Isaac Newton. He was reading a book in the shade of an apple tree. All of a sudden, an apple fell on his head. He picks it up and looks at it, and then he starts thinking about what just happened.
At first, he thought about the sun, and then about the alternation of day and night.
Does any of you kids know what are day and night? Actually, they are the effects of Earth spinning, because this spinning actually creates day and night. It's also a factor that determines the Earth's Saturn's shape. But the seasons, they are the effects of Earth's revolution. As the Earth floats around the Sun, it floats on an oval trajectory, so that are the planet orbits closer to the Sun, it's summer. And as the planet orbits further, down here it's winter. Now let me tell you something that you might know. One spinning motion is completed in approximately 24 hours, while a revolution motion is completed in 1 year.
Have you ever wondered why we can see the moon every night? The answer is the following.
Earth gravitationally interacts with other objects in space, especially the sun and the moon. During one orbit around the sun, the Earth rotates about its own axis 366 times, creating 365 solar days, or one sidereal year. The moon is Earth's only natural satellite. It began orbiting the Earth about 4 billion years ago. The moon's gravitational interactions with Earth stimulates ocean tides, stabilizes the axial tilt, and gradually slows the planet's rotation.
Now let's talk about the structure of Earth.
Does any of you kids have any idea what is this planet that we live on?
No? Great, let me tell you. Earth, as we usually call it, it's like a big onion. Yeah, I'm not kidding. It really is like a huge onion, looking like a flattened sphere along the axis from north to south, floating and spinning around the sun. Why do you think I'm calling the Earth onion? Well, I'm calling it like that because it has layers. Yeah, you heard right, it has layers. Sure, not as many as an onion, but it has layers. Only three. And they are the core layer, the Earth's mantle, and finally, the crust. Each of these layers has one or more sublayers. For example, the core. It has the internal layer, which can reach up to 5000 Celsius degrees, and it's situated at about 6000 kilometers under our feet. The core also has the external layer, that is a little bit cooler than the internal layer, so it can only reach up to 2900 Celsius degrees. And it's situated at about 2900 kilometers in the ground. Quite a long distance, I think. Okay kids, now let's talk a bit about the crust. It is made by two sublayers, just like the core. The first sublayer is the oceanic crust, which is about 5 to 10 kilometers thick. The second sublayer of the crust is the continental crust, that is made by several pieces named continents, and it's floating on a red hot liquid, the lava, just like the oceanic crust.
The next topic we are going to talk about is the Earth's resources.
The Earth provides resources that are exploitable by humans for useful purposes. Some of these are non-renewable resources such as mineral fuels that are difficult to replenish on a short time scale. Large deposits of fossil fuels are obtained from the Earth's crust consisting of coal, petroleum and natural gas. These deposits are used by humans both for energy production as a feedstock for chemical production. Mineral ore bodies have also been formed in Earth's crust through a process of orogenesis resulting from actions of erosion and plate tectonics. These bodies form concentrated sources of many metals and other useful elements. The Earth's biosphere produces many useful biological products for humans, including, but far from limited to, food, wood, pharmaceuticals, oxygen, and the recycling of many organic wastes. The land-based ecosystem depends upon topsoil and fresh water, and the oceanic ecosystem depends upon dissolved nutrients washed down from the land.
That was all for today, kids. Thank you for watching, and we hope you all enjoyed our little attempt to present the Earth.